Good morning students. Today we start with the section the condition of change of state differ from substance to substance. We know that water freezing or melting at 0 degree Celsius and boiling at 100 degree Celsius, and that of ethanol is boiling point is 78 degree Celsius. So the melting point and boiling point are the characteristics of a substance. So we can determining this melting and boiling point, we can identify the substance. So the condition of change of state is differ from substance to substance because the intermolecular force and intermolecular space is differ from one substance to another. That is why the different substance have different melting point and different boiling point. Next section is conservation of mass. We already know that in a chemical change there is a rearrangement of atoms or molecules taking place, and the atoms or molecules in a substance have fixed masses. So the total mass of substance involved in a change is always same. So Lavoisier gave a law called law of conservation of mass, which states that matter can neither be created nor destroyed, but it can be changed from one form to another, and the total mass of substance before and after the change remains the same. This law is called law of conservation of mass. This law of conservation of mass is true for physical as well as chemical changes, and the total mass of substance before and after the change is the same. Now we can explaining different example for physical change and chemical change. First we taking physical changes. We already studied physical changes. In a physical change there is no change in mass of substance. Example, mass of the electric bulb. It does not change, after it remains lightened for some time. So there is no change in the mass of the substance. Similarly, if we take a given mass of ice, on melting it gives same mass of water, and if we boiling that given mass of water, it gives same mass of water. So in a physical change there is no change in the total mass of substance. Now next we taking chemical changes. Chemical changes is also obey the law of conservation of mass. In a chemical change the sum of mass of reactant is same as that of product. That is mass of the reactant equal to mass of products. Example, burning a piece of paper. During this process we can see that the paper take oxygen from air, form some ash plus carbon dioxide and water vapor. So the total mass of paper plus oxygen taken from the air equal to the ash plus carbon dioxide and water vapor. So in that experiment the mass of paper plus oxygen equal to mass of ash plus carbon dioxide plus water vapor. So the chemical change obey law of conservation of mass. Simple experiment we can explain this law of conservation of mass is, take a small bottle containing barium chloride solution in a conical flask and add some sodium sulfate solution using dropper to the conical flask. Then the conical flask is closed using cork and take the weight of the total conical flask. So we get total weight of the conical flask. Third step, we tilt the flask and swirl it slowly. When we mixing these two solutions, it form some product here. And again, we weighing this mass after the complete chemical change, we can see that the total mass of conical flask remains the same. That is, the mass of reactant equal to mass of product. So we can simply tell the chemical change also obey law of conservation of mass. So our first unit is over. Next class we move to the question answer. Thank you.